The July 7th, 2015 Wentworth Town Council meeting will now come to order. If you would, bow your heads for the invocation, please. Dear Lord, please be with us as we make decisions for the town tonight. Help us to make the right decisions for everyone. Be with those that protect us both at home and overseas. Be with the sick. Of course, in your name we pray. Amen. First item on the agenda is approval of the town council agenda. Don't have any addendums for that, so I'll make a motion we approve the agenda as written.
A second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. The next item on the agenda is approval of the minutes from the town council meeting of June 2nd, 2015. Everybody has a copy.
I make a motion to be accepted as written.
I second. I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? If not all those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Don't have any old business. We'll move on to new business under A, consideration of a residential lease agreement and application for 8286 NC87. George?
Thank you, Mayor. You have two documents in your packets. One is a North Carolina residential lease agreement, and the other is a Town of Wentworth application to rent form. The residential lease agreement that you have there is a document that was provided by Smithmore Leatherwood and has been modified with the information that is applicable to just the town. And this is for the house that we have next door to Town Hall that the town has rented in the past. We've completed most of the repair work and everything on that. What I'm asking for is if you look over this document, there are a few details that are in here. Under page 1 of 6 on the duration, the initial lease is a one calendar year lease, and then after that it goes to a month by month rental. On page 2 of 6, under rent, the rental payment during duration is $700 a month. Under security deposit, the amount of the security deposit is $700, and that is refundable. Then under animals and pets, I need your input on this, of whether or not that the town will allow pets to be there in the house. The previous renter did have more than one dog, I think, at one point in time,
okay,
and had a cat as well, so they had three animals there. And the way that this was initially written was the animal fee was a $250 deposit, and that was done per animal on this particular document. But before, we simply had a $250 deposit, animal deposit. Now, when we did, that last lease was terminated, there was some damage to a storm door, and we got an estimate on what it was to repair that. That was deducted from the general deposit and the security deposit. And there were some scratch marks and stuff on one of the door facings and stuff that had to be corrected and painted. And the repair of that was deducted from the animal or pet deposit to cover the cost of those repairs when the previous tenant moved out. So I guess the question is, those particular areas that I've highlighted on the lease agreement and the question about on the animal fee, do you want that simply to be a $250 deposit, or do you want it to be per animal?
Did we have anything as far as the animals being allowed inside last time, any stipulations?
No, they were simply, pets were allowed, and so they were allowed inside.
Yeah. You know, a lot of places don't allow pets inside because you run into that. The damage that occurred, I guess it got fixed satisfactorily?
Yes.
That would get kind of expensive if it was $250 per animal.
Yes.
But sometimes animals can do damage.
They can.
Yeah.
Well, in this particular case, what we had is, I think the dog had been placed into one of the front bedroom areas. and the door was closed and the animal had scratched on the door and taken paint off. Yeah. So we had to have a painter match the paint and correct it, sand it and correct it. And like, and it was only a portion of that $250 pet deposit that was used to correct that.
I think we ought to go with a per animal fee, but I think we ought to limit the number of animals that can be in the house too.
Okay.
To say two.
Okay. So no more than two?
Yeah, because if you get three or four animals in there and you shut them off from one another and they're trying to get to each other, they could tear up two or three doors at a time.
Okay. And go with $250 per animal?
Yeah.
Are the other, and those are the only real questions that, that I see. Frankie was the one who sent this, and it's very similar to what you see from the, was it Realtors Association or something? But Realtors Association leases are copyrighted by the Realtors Association, so that's why we have this particular document here. So I guess what I would ask is, if, with those changes, with what's already in the underlying portions and keeping the animal fee at $250 per animal with a limitation of no more than two animals, is what you're suggesting we would pass?
Yes.
Do you want to handle this separately from the application?
We can. I make a motion that we, a motion to that effect. You want to go over it one more time?
Yes, that the duration will be for, initial duration will be for one calendar year. The rental payment is $700 per month. The security deposit is $700. And under animals and pets, the animal fee will be $250 per animal with no more than two animals allowed.
Have a motion. Can I get a second?
I second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Okay. With regard to the application to rent form, initially I went online and looked at several different versions, and I couldn't find one that I really felt was adequate for what our needs were. And I had one that I had used before for a home that I had rented. So I modified that particular document, and then I sent it to Pat for legal review, and he in turn sent it to Frankie. Frankie Jones is the one from Smithmore Leatherwood who also had reviewed the post office lease. And Frankie made several adjustments to the document. You'll notice that it is going to be a front and back document. I would suggest that the document is in pretty good shape with the exception of the application fee. And you'll notice that that's highlighted on the copy that you have there. One of the things is whether we would do a credit check or a tenant background check. And I have communicated with Frankie with email about that. There are a couple of different methods that we could use to do that. But the one that seems to be the most viable would be to use a tenant background search. And the cost of those can run anywhere from $19.95 if you get just a, it includes a nationwide criminal record, sex offender, and Patriot Act search, or you get what they call their comprehensive tenant screening, which is $29.95. So I would recommend to you that we have an application fee so that we could use that service of $30 for an application for to rent the home, and that be included on the document.
That's a good idea.
Okay.
The only other thing that that Frankie and I have discussed on this is that because this is a town document or with a municipal government, that the document that is submitted, an application that is submitted, would be subject to public records. And there is certain information that's contained in here that if it were called on as a public record, that would have to be redacted, and staff could do that if that came up. He was doing some additional research on that, but I think we've identified what areas on the application would have to be redacted if it was called for in a public records request.
Okay.
So my recommendation is that we, just to counsel, is that you approve this document with an application fee being $30.
I make a motion that we approve this draft of the Town of Wentworth application to rent form for 8286 NC Highway 87, Reedsville, North Carolina 27320, and include a $30 application fee.
I second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not everybody in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you. Under B, under new business, consideration of a review of formalized financial cash management policy, section 1-B7, review of authorized check signers. Yvonne?
The town's formalized financial cash management policy states that we have to review the authorized check signers annually. These check signers are listed on a signature card at Fidelity Bank with our checking account. The current check signers are Dennis Paschal Jr., Evelyn Connor, George T. Murphy Sr., and Yvonne Russell. Unless you want to make a change, you can approve the current list of check signers.
Okay. I make a motion we approve the current list of check signers.
Second.
It's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
Yeah.
Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. She said she was waiting to see if you were going to second it.
Since we were on it.
All right. Next item on the agenda under C is discussion of the USPS zip code realignment, bottom line delivery for Wentworth, North Carolina. We had talked about after the we got the post office opened up down there, we had so much stuff going on that we would look at the bottom line delivery at that point in time. And there's a couple of options there, and George, I want to turn it over to you to explain those two since you checked on it there.
Okay. Well, bottom line delivery is something that town council had addressed before, even back in the years when I was on town council. And even my wife kind of did a lot of research and everything on about the post office and getting what at that time we were calling bottom line delivery. Since I was aware that council was interested in still looking into that, I've kind of kept notes on it. And I told you earlier when we were working on the post office and Chris Dahl, who was with in the Greensboro office with the facilities implementation team, as early as March 19th, I was copied on an email from Chris, and it was a conversation that he was having with Kathleen Ferrante Green, who was with Tango Incorporated, and Tango apparently was a subcontractor who was dealing with AT&T, and they were trying to validate the address of 200 County Home Road so that AT&T could install a phone service for the phone company. The town installed or got the line installed by AT&T to the building. They wanted to be able to connect from the building to where their offices were located at 200 County Home Road, and they couldn't validate the address. And what it really boiled down to was the United States Postal Service and AT&T couldn't find the place because Wentworth didn't have bottom line delivery. And it just absolutely blew me away. That you know, Chris was having that much difficulty, and so those emails started March 11th. I was copied on them on March the 19th, and I finally responded to some of the Postal Service people and to the Kathleen Ferrante Green and with Tango Incorporated, which that was in New Jersey, I think was right. And there were folks with the Postal Service in Greensboro who were involved in it, and folks with the Postal Service in Raleigh who were involved with it. And eventually said, this is why I think you're having the trouble. If you try to put it in GPS this way, I think you'll find it, and put it as Reedsville, North Carolina, you might can find it. And they did eventually, and of course got it installed. Well, part of that conversation, one of the people in Raleigh was James Brackens with the Postal Service. And in my conversation or email conversation with him, I said, I think town council is going to want me to work on this. And if they do, who can you help me out with who I need to be in touch with? He in turn forwarded my email to a couple of folks with the Postal Service in Tennessee. They in turn got in touch with somebody out of the Greensboro office. And her name is Karen Robertson Tippin. She's with the Postal Service Greensboro District Office on Boundary Review Operations. And she called me back. Turns out her husband, by the way, is employed over here at the DMV just outside of town limits. And she talked about having difficulty using GPS finding things in Wentworth, too. Mm-hmm. So that was kind of entertaining. When I returned her call, I asked her about changing the last line from Reedsville, NC 27320 to Wentworth, North Carolina 27375. And we've always called that bottom line delivery. Karen said that there were really what were called two options. Option one is to go with what they call preferential last line. Preferential last line would read Wentworth, NC 27320, which is the Reedsville zip code. Okay? The other option is to go with what they call zip code realignment, and what we've called that in the past bottom line delivery. Zip code realignment would mean that mail in Wentworth would then go to Wentworth, North Carolina 27375, which is the Wentworth zip code. She also noted the following, that currently the delivery of mail within the town of Wentworth is spread out over several different mail routes. There's more than not just one. There's several routes, rural routes that cover it. She said there are about four or five that include area within the corporate limits of the town. The process would include a written request to the district manager. They currently had an acting district manager, Jason DeChambeau. The regular district manager is Russell Gardner, and his office is at the Gallimore Dairy Road office in Greensboro, which I think also is where Chris Dahl's office is located. Then to recognize that a zip code realignment would result in some cost to residents and businesses because of changing addresses, that was something to be aware of. She also said the process was that the people who were affected would be surveyed by the U.S. Postal Service and that 51% of those surveyed would constitute the majority. If the proposal is rejected by the survey, respondents, then we would have to wait a minimum of 10 years before the next attempt to support a zip code realignment. So I guess what I need to know from you is if how you want to direct me to proceed with this. Are you more interested in the zip code realignment, or are you more interested in the preferential last line? And is this something that town council wants to go after?
In the preferential, that would leave the zip code the same as 27320.
Yes.
But you would be changing the town name. So if you're going to change the town name, you may as well, if they're going from Reedsville Wentworth, they may as well change the zip code too,
right,
to the one that we're using down here.
We already got the zip code. We just need to put the name and the zip code
right
together.
So I would tend to lean towards using the Wentworth, North Carolina, with the Wentworth zip code to 27375. Does anybody else have any?
Because you wait 10 years, I'm going to be dead and gone. I'm not going to get sick. Unless I'm going to live to be old.
You never can tell, Iris. And what we can do is, and of course this just allows the residents in the town of Wentworth to vote through a survey on whether or not they want to have their address changed. We're not making the decision here. We're just asking the post office to survey these folks. Of course, we will tell them, as far as the zip code realignment, what we're looking at there. But it'll be up to the individuals.
Let me ask you a question, Dennis.
Right.
Who pays for the notice to go out to all these customers? Do we or does the U.S. government?
Well, we're going to get George to find that out. Now, we'll probably run some ads in the paper to make people aware of what's going on. Mm-hmm. But what we'll do is we'll say, okay, George, we want to proceed with this, and then we'll have George check on all that and find out and come back to us at the August meeting, and we'll be able to proceed. I imagine once we make the request and they get started on it, it probably shouldn't take too awful long, maybe a couple of months for them to do it, but we don't know right now.
I would have, if you want me to proceed with that, then what I would do is probably contact Karen Robertson, and in all likelihood, either Jason DeChambeau or Russell Gardner, whoever's in that position, and find out kind of what the timeline is, what all the procedures and tick and tack are, and just so that we have all the details with that. And I can find out then, of course, what does the Postal Service handle, and of course, we know if we do advertising or any kind of communication or shared, whatever our cost would be.
And then he can get back with us at the August meeting and let us know the answers to those questions. So, and what we can do is just proceed with the, ask George to start on the zip code realignment with the Postal Service, and then get back with us in August and let us know what's going to be involved. And then we can decide, once he finds out what the timeline, how long it'll take, then we can decide if we want to run some ads in the paper to make people aware. And we'll probably have the numbers out so people can call here if they've got any questions about it and talk to George and them as far as, you know, what you need to do to be able to change the address and stuff like that. Is everybody okay with the zip code realignment of the 27375 to put out there? Okay. Then I make a motion that we proceed with a zip code realignment and have George contact the Postal Service and find out what the timetable is and what we need to do and get back with us at our August meeting.
My second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. And if anything pops up and we need to talk to folks in between, you know, between now and then, say, you know, just let us know and we can get in touch with, or y'all can get in touch with council and let them know what's going on that. But probably, you know, won't anything happen before August anyway, I wouldn't imagine.
Other than they will be disturbed by me.
Yeah. Okay. All right. We don't have any public comments for tonight. I'll move on to the announcements. If you're considering running for elected office, candidate filing begins on Monday, July 6th at 8 a.m., which was yesterday.
Yesterday.
And ends at noon on July 17th, 2015. So you've got 11 days there. Is that a Friday or a Saturday?
Friday.
Okay. The next regular meeting of the Wentworth Planning Board is July 21st, 2015 at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers. And the next regular meeting of the Wentworth Town Council is August 4th, 2015 at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers. Does anybody have any other announcements? If not, I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Everybody in favor, say aye.
Aye. Aye.